I think curiosity is about expanding that bank of things that you care about. And that idea of fostering curiosity is partly about showing that the students can understand difficult things, that they can take on difficult topics, and that the learning can be their own. Even though that there are these state standards that we have to cover, that doesn't mean that the learning can't be applied in a really rich and relevant way.
Welcome everybody to AP Statistics class today. We're actually going to be looking at some really cool real-world data right from our backyard. This is actually my first year teaching AP Statistics, so it's a great challenge for me to deliver it in an understandable and approachable way for my students. And then also to develop like some interest in it, right? And that comes from really getting to know your students first. Many of the Greene School students really care about the environment. I chose this because I figured this is like a super cool tool to start to like dig into environmental justice.
In this lesson, we will be looking at the data available in the Tree Equity Score Analyzer.
We have an amazing instructional coach, and she introduced that Tree Equity Score website to me. It shows kind of the canopy or the coverage of trees in all the different blocks in like the urban areas of the United States. There's all different statistics that you can layer on top of it. You can look at poverty, you can look at race, and you can look at all the different things that like a general census would kind of collect. And the one that we're really going to be looking at today, guys, is people in poverty. And the whole idea is to be able to take statistics and to take the tree equity score and kind of target our resources most efficiently for planting trees. For instance, the one that I clicked has a tree equity score of 85. And if we look here, people in poverty, 39%. So we were looking at Providence, Rhode Island. We're going to be looking to see if there is some kind of overall trend between those two. Next, I had the kids create a scatter plot, and they had to locate all of that data on their own. And the goal was to create a random sampling, so they had some representation from each part of the city.
I noticed that like in the east side, they had the highest tree equity number.
But like the southern side is such a low score.
They took that data, and then they fed it into a statistical software that is used to create scatter plots. Then they use the least square regression line to create a line that best fits the data. And they were using it to make a prediction in the data set. It's called interpolation.
I feel like you think that if you were poor, there'd be less trees, but that's not the case.
Yeah.
It's not like this clean, kind of like artificial data set. There was a lot to like interpret. So as the tree equity score is going up, what's happening to our value there?
It's decreasing.
It's decreasing.
People in poverty are going down.
Yeah. People in poverty are going down. And they would notice that, yes, it's a linear relationship, but it's not like super strong.
I didn't think that the tree equity rate was directly linked to the amount of poverty. When you see high number, there's definitely lower poverty rates, but it's not always like that in all the parts of the town.
Trying to think more of the actual context of the problem itself and not just the math, that's like a huge part of AP statistics, is always referring to the context of the problem. Maybe there's a better way to kind of link these two with the tree equity score, and it might be like population density.